Today, I'm going to take a grammar topic from your English text, my English book, practice book. And the topic is simple, compound, and complex sentences. Simple, compound, and complex sentences. What is a sentence? A sentence is a group of words that makes a complete sense on its own. A sentence needs to have a verb and a subject. Or we can divide a sentence into two parts, a subject and predicate. Subject is the doer of the action. And the predicate contains the action and other parts. So in this video, you are going to learn about simple sentences, compound sentences, and complex sentences. So what is a simple sentence? A simple sentence is called an independent clause. It contains a subject and a verb and expresses a complete thought. For example, Scott plays soccer in the morning. So here, plays is the verb and Scott is the subject. So Scott is the subject and plays soccer in the morning is the predicate. A compound sentence contains two independent clauses joined by a coordinating conjunction. For example, Scott was playing soccer, so Mary went to the beach. So Scott was playing soccer is also a complete, gives a complete meaning. Mary went to the beach also gives us a complete meaning. So both are independent clauses and they are joined by a coordinating conjunction. So in a compound sentences, you will find two independent clauses. So these are the coordinating conjunctions. Fanboys, for, and, nor, but, or, yet, so. So in a compound sentence, two independent clauses are combined using these coordinating conjunctions, any of these. So here is another example. Jake drove the car and Mary read the map. Now let's see what's a complex sentence. A complex sentence combines an independent clause with one or more dependent clauses. A complex sentence always has a subordinating conjunction. Here, Scott wore his football boots is the main clause. And because is the conjunction and he was playing soccer is a dependent clause. Means the dependent clause depends on the main clause. He was playing soccer doesn't give us a complete meaning. We don't know who is he. We will get the complete meaning only when you read the first part, that is the main clause. So such a sentence is a complex sentence. So these are the subordinating conjunctions. You can read them. And this is another example for a complex sentence. The children saw many interesting science experiments when they went on their excursion. Here also the first part, the main clause, it gives a complete meaning. Whereas the second part, they went on their excursion. We don't know who are they. Doesn't give us a complete sense. So it's a dependent clause and joined by when. So I hope you all understood simple, compound, and complex sentences. Go through this video again and again till you understand the concept, and do the worksheets which I am going to send. So thank you, children.